Good day mga ka-people, Cebu People's Multipurpose Cooperative warmly welcome the newly appointed chairperson of the CDA, Honorable Joseph Encabo. Together with Asik Abad Santos, Asik Marilla Paradillo, Asik Vidal Villanueva III, CDA Regional Director 6 and 7, Cebu's cooperative leaders here at Hiksahol Basak, Lapu-Lapu City. Now, let's take a look of the Kumustahan event with our special guest.
Chairperson sa CDA, aron ato ang mahimamat, labi na sa ato ang mga kaubanan ng mga board of directors, no, aron sila sad makapangutana kung unsa mga kabaguhan ng mga palisiya, no, sa pagkakaroon. O being the new installed CDA chairman, so muna nga kinahanglan ato siyang paminaon. O muna ni ang higayon nga mahimo gyud nato ang tanan ato ang mga pangutana aron kita magiyahan sa mga kabaguhan labi na sa kaning mga clusters officers, no, nga samtang kita multi-purpose cooperative doon ata sa housing na ata sa transport o credit sa financial, no. So ani karon ang mga assistant secretary kauban sa atong undersecretary para ato sila mapaminaw, no. This is a very good opportunity para sa ato nga nakuha nato ang ilahang panahon sa bisan sa ilahang kabisi nga wala kita gibalibaran, no. Daghang salamat kaayo para ni ana. Ato pasalamatan ang Ginoo.
The conversation with Cooperative Development Authority is a great privilege and honor to talk about various cooperative challenges, plans and programs.
Meron mang sector that is badly hit by this pandemic is the labor sector, which I am heading the human services cluster, which includes labor, workers, housing, and the health. Nakakalungkot kasi kung merong bugbog na husto ngayon sa pandemic, it is my cluster, the labor and workers sa cooperative. But hindi tayo nawawala ng pag-asa, no, na tayo makabangon, at napakasarap naman na namnamin yung pagbangon mula sa pagkadapa, ano. At ang aking sektor ay nagtutulungan. Marami kaming hinihingi na tulong galing sa dole na sana tayo ay pagbigyan, dahil wala naman tayong pwedeng takbuhan sa panahon ngayon kundi ang ating gobyerno. Ang gusto ko sana talaga, ang aking workers at labor ay magsama-sama with the health. Kung yung health ay nangangailangan ng mga tao, hindi na sila kukuha sa mga agency kung dito na sila sa labor sector, sa labor cooperative. At yung labor cooperatives naman at saka workers, kung nangangailangan sila ng health, medical, at saka yung kanila mga pre-need sa medical, doon na sa ating health cooperatives. And so with the housing. So meron tayong mga projects na sana nakaabang, but with this pandemic, limited ang aming pagkilos. So sana matapos the soonest possible ang ating problema. Again, kailangan lagi may pag-asa. Hindi tayo mag-stay lang dahil sa ganitong sitwasyon. Laban lang kung laban.
That are confronting the transport cooperative sector today is number one, the issue of the service contracting na hindi nababayaran, ang issue ng mga LPTRP, coming from the LGUs na until now ay hindi pa rin nagagawa, no? Yun, those are the big issues confronting the sector right now.
Finance cluster cooperatives are facing a lot of troubles and problems, especially on the collection doon sa mga cooperative members na nakapag-loan sa ating mga cooperative. And because of this, we will be talking to our cooperative, primary cooperatives, to provide them with the guidance on how to assist our cooperative members and how to help yung mga cooperative members natin na ma-recover yung kanilang exposure to the COVID. And aside from that, this coming August 6, we will be convening with all the cooperative banks all over the country together with the DBP in order for us to find ways how our government can assist our cooperative banks as well as our primary cooperatives.
I have introduced a lot of plans to my members of the board of directors in CDA, as well as laying down the cards to the regional directors and offices and to the entire CDA as an institution, that the reforms and changes will occur starting from us as an institution, as an agency of government. And I believe that we have a good start by coming up with a resolution that all reportorial requirements and registration requirements will be trimmed down and streamlined into half. So this is the response of the CDA on the ease of doing business and allowing the cooperatives to be more compliant because of the revised reportorial requirements, and encouraging the organizations and associations to become a cooperative. But the main advocacy of CDA will focus on the micro, small, and transport cooperatives. These are the sectors in the cooperative movement that need to be assisted and alleviate them from their current status. And we want them to graduate from their current status to a higher level in the cooperative movement, from micro to small, small to medium, medium to large.
Cebu People's Multipurpose Cooperative is truly grateful for the positive outcome coming from our CDA leaders themselves. Furthermore, our cooperative has always been proud of the achievements, which opens a door of opportunity for the members, employees, and officers. In fact, we produce efficient leaders who committedly serve the people. Our very own chairperson of the board, Mr. Manolito Ardimer, was elected as the first ever chairperson of the Visayas Federation of Transport Cooperative in Region 7.
Nangamo lang yung katuyuan, una mao ang pagkanang federate jud sa tibuok nga transport cooperative diri sa Visayas. Nang usa sa buluhaton kay nga dako mao ang amo sang surbehon kun unsa man jud ang mga legitimate nga kinsa man jud ang mga legitimate nga transport cooperative nga posible nga ma-appeal sa atong federation, no? Nya pag humana na iskutan siguro unsa man ang mga galastuhan sa pagkuana niya kanang registration na into federation. So usa na siya nga dako kay buluhaton. Nang katuyuan nang jud nganong atong i-federate kay para ang dunay collaboration ang mga transport nga mga cooperative diri sa Visayas labi na sa Cebu, so dili ingon nga competition kundi dunay collaboration unya pagtabang pod ni atong sa mangyud ang mga kalisdanan sa mga transport cooperative nga karon galisod pa mangyud sila sa pagpadagan o pagkuha gani og unit. So sana nga matabangan siguro maplanuhan sa federation.
This event signifies the collaboration in pursuit of empowerment and inclusive growth.
We have witnessed the Kumustahan event with the Cooperative Development Authority, in which cooperative matters such as concerns, plans, future programs were tackled. This is your Co-op Ambassador Jacob Lyon for Mang People TV.